What's up, Internet? It's Dumbass Panicos Gaming. Maybe this time the fucking recording will work. But yeah, so we're doing some more shiny hunting tonight. And yeah. So it's been a little bit since I streamed. Just last week I was not in the mood for it. I don't know. I didn't feel particularly great on a... Okay, now why the fuck am I dropping frames too? Jesus fucking Christ. I think that was probably because of the fucking recording hiccup. If I have to assume. Because it isn't like doing it a lot. But yeah, so yeah, last Friday I streamed. And I wasn't feeling great, and then Saturday and Sunday I kind of got fucked over with work, and there was no way I was going to be able to stream. And then so just during the week I was just like, fuck it, I'm just not even going to worry about it. Just take the rest of the week off. And then yesterday I really don't have an excuse. Boy, it'd be great if I can get another fucking egg. I have a feeling tonight's going to be one of those nights that I don't do very much streaming, because... Holy shit, this is already off to be a fucking disaster. Fucking OBS is being a piece of shit, which, nothing really new there, but I mean, more so than normal. Sometime this decade could I get a fifth egg. I'm not dealing with this shit tonight, dude. Yeah, I'm not really sure why I didn't stream yesterday, to be honest. Other than just I was just not in the mood. And based on how tonight's going, maybe that was a good idea. But yeah, hopefully we can get this tonight. I don't know. I'm already frustrated. I kind of wasn't in the mood to stream tonight either, but it was like, well, I kind of have to. I can't be taking, like, weeks off. Last week, I kind of got screwed, so, I mean, it's not really my fault. Just, again, my work schedule kind of got fucked over because just everything got fucked, pretty much. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what's going on with all my shit today. But I did get some other shit done. Not for the stream, because heaven forbid I do anything with the stream. But I've been playing a lot of other games recently, which has been nice. I finally finished up Heartspace Shipbreaker. Boy, talk about a game that nobody... Literally no one on the face of the planet asked for a story in that game, as far as I can tell, and they made it as annoying as possible, which is always good, because, like, literally in no way at any point does that story affect playing the game whatsoever. The only exception to that is the very last mission, and it's just, like, by the time you get to that point, like, I loaded into my last ship to that. I was like, okay, if the story doesn't progress after this, I'm just done with this game. I'm not going to keep pushing through it. And then finally, like, started progressing again. But it's just like, it's just stupid because it doesn't affect the story, or it doesn't affect the gameplay in any way, except for, again, the last mission. And it's just. I guess it does affect the gameplay, because it constantly gets in the way of you playing the game. Like, it'll just, you have to stop and just listen to people talk. And then finally you get to, like, the third chapter, and it's just, like, so dumb and unenjoyable. All, like, the commentary that happens. Because it's basically just, oh, I guess we're just slaves for the company now. It's like, cool. this is so interesting. Thank you for spending a bunch of time on this. Plus, by this point, like, you've pretty much experienced the entire game, so you're just trying to, like, finish up. And there's really not enough variety to make you want to keep playing after that. Like, yeah, there's always something slightly different with each of the ships, but usually it's not something that you want to be different. Like the whole decompression and stuff like that. Or, you know, like compartments of the ship being pressurized and whatnot is just like not a great mechanic. I'm bitching about the game a lot. I enjoyed it for what it was, but like by the end of my time with it, I was pretty done with it. So as soon as I wrapped up that story and got my last Xbox achievement, I was just like, okay, cool. Uninstall. I don't need to ever play this again. It's a shame because if they dealt with like a couple of the issues and like added a couple more ships, it could be okay. And you can tell they meant for there to be more shit too. Because like there's like a danger level rating or a hazard level rating or whatever you want to call it for each ship. And as you progress, they get more, there's more and more hazards. But even though there's room in like the marking or like the bar that displays, you know, how hazard it is for up to level 10, it only goes up to level 9, and there's no level 10 whatsoever. And also just like there's little things like the thrusters on one of the ships are completely different from the others, but all the others are identical. And it's just like there's so much wasted potential, it feels like. And as far as I can tell, that a lot of that happened because they decided they really needed to put a story into the game, because a lot of people were telling them during development, like, hey, like, you know, we need more stuff. And it's like, nope, we need to make a story. And the story is just not enjoyable. So it's just like, okay, cool, thanks. Glad you guys did that. And they've already said they're not there's not going to be any meaningful content updates. So it's like, you guys, like, it feels like the story is complete, but like the content isn't, almost. Like, it still feels like an early access game in terms of what there is to do. And so it's just like, why? Why would you do that? No, like, the game doesn't need a story at all. If it was just taking apart the ships, it'd be pretty cool. But yeah, so I wrapped that up. I started playing Art of Rally, finally. Because I finally got around to that. I was just, I actually cleaned out a bunch of stuff on my games, like, lists on Steam and, Xbox and stuff. Because, like, I've had, Slime Rancher installed forever. I played it a little bit on Game Pass, but never really put much time into it. I really like Slime Rancher, I couldn't stick with it, at least at the time. And I think now I'm just gonna wait for the new one to come out. Or like Stardew Valley, which granted isn't a very large install, but like I've had that installed both on Steam and on Game Pass because I was like, oh yeah, I'll play it for achievements on Game Pass. Why I would do that, I don't know. That game's too long to be playing for achievements. And it's not like I'm gonna, you know, get the full 1,000 very quickly. Or ever, honestly, because some of those achievements are actually kind of hard. Like the Journey of the Prairie King or whatever. Yeah, so I uninstalled a bunch of stuff. Anyway, so I started playing Art of Rally finally because I was like, well, I should probably play this at some point. I didn't think it was going to be a very long game. I guess it wasn't. I mean, I pushed through it in like 3 days, but that's also because I pretty much no-lifed that game for 3 days. God, I really like Art of Rally. It takes a little bit to get used to it because the physics aren't the greatest. They're kind of too slidey, it feels like, but they are consistent. Like, you can learn them, and I've gotten decently good at it. But God, the art style and the music is just perfect. Just so good. I'm actually working on a long ass video for it that probably isn't going to be like anything that's like too interesting. It's pretty much just going to be a compilation of the full OST and then all of the or a lot of gameplay. But it's just like, it's an excuse for me to play more of that game. And then, I was looking at, potentially buying House Flipper recently. Because, like, I watched another streamer play it. It's a game that I've been kind of interested in for a while. And so when I saw them play, I was like, okay, you know what, maybe I should just pull the trigger on this. I know I'll have fun with it. Or at least I think I'm going to have fun with it. And then I was like, well, let's wait for a paycheck to come in before we buy any games on the Steam sale. And sure enough, literally the day after I said I was going to wait on it, it popped up on Game Pass. And so I was like, oh, okay, cool. I guess I'll just play it for free then. But yeah, House Flipper, not sure how I feel about it yet. I like a lot of it. I don't like that for, like, actually flipping houses. Like, when you buy a house and repair it to sell it, you're expected to put a shit ton of furniture in it. I really don't like that. Because, like, if you buy a house, it doesn't come with a couch and a TV. That's not a thing. It doesn't come with an office computer. Like, yeah, appliances like the oven and the refrigerator, you know, stuff like that, yeah, it'll come with, usually. Let me check this real quick. Do I have anything to knock this thing out? I would rather not just run away from it if I don't have to. What level is it? 21? God, why does that move suck so much? I really need to make this chandelier better. Okay, well, I guess we're just gonna run. I just wanted to check to see if there was a chance it would have the boosted odds, but... Or not even a chance to have boosted odds, just a chance to be shiny, but... Anyways. But yeah, I don't know. Like, I like all the stuff about, like... refurbishing the houses and all that, but, like... the fact that you're expected to, like... put beds in the bedrooms and stuff like that. I'm not talking about, like, the contract jobs where, like, people... asking you to do something to their house. I'm specifically talking about the buying a house to refurbish. And it's like, that's not a thing. So it's just annoying because, like, I love the, like, repairing the house part of it. I don't like the fact that I'm basically expected to just, like, fill it with nonsense to, like, min-max gauges for getting certain people to buy the house. And, like, the contract stuff, again, that I kind of mentioned that, like, oh, hey, I need, like, this wall destroyed and I need, you know, stuff repainted and stuff like that. Like, that's okay, I guess, but it's not that interesting to me. I might have double-counted this one, by the way. But yeah, I don't know. I just, like, I feel like the meat of the game should be the repairing houses, not... or, like, flip it. I mean, again, the name of the game is House Flipper, so I feel like that should be the core of it. But because you have to basically do interior design, it's like, I don't know. I'll probably play it some more, but I'm probably not going to play it as much as I was expecting to, which is a shame. But Game Pass, so I'm glad I didn't buy that. But yeah, I did go through all my shit and, like, figure out what shit I want to play, like, well, stuff that I was never gonna play, which now that I say that, I'm not coming up with any examples off the top of my head. I think stuff like Skyrim. So, like, I've had Skyrim on my Steam library for a while, and I've kept thinking, like, oh yeah, maybe I'll go back and play through that. It's just like, no, I won't. No, I won't. I don't care about Skyrim. Like, it's, I think I played it for a little bit on PC, like, not too long ago, actually, even, like, within the last year, I think. But then I, you know, I did what I, you know, I played it for like 3 or 4 days and then I got bored of it. So I moved on. Cause I mean, when Skyrim originally came out, I played the fuck out of it. I got the platinum trophy on PS3. Boy, was playing that game on PS3 mistake. Yeah, I don't know. It's just like, there's no point in me keeping that in my playlist. Oh, also, I need to fix that little box popping, because it's, I'm not going to be streaming 5 times a week for a while. I think I'll be streaming maybe 3 times a week. I shouldn't say maybe. I will be streaming 3 times a week. Again, when I'm not getting screwed in my actual job. And then maybe we'll do a 4th, but we'll see. It has been really nice to, like, on my actual days off, because I don't really work on Tuesday and Wednesday. That's why, like, that's usually when I plan on my midweek streams being. But it's just, like, it's been really nice not caring about that at all. And just being like, nah, I'm just going to take the day off. Not give a shit at all. So we'll see. But yeah, I'm definitely, a little burned out with Pokemon. I think the reason is that I started shiny hunting off stream as well. And that just kind of really snowballed things into going kind of out of control. So I was just like, burnt out a little bit. So I think my goal right now is I'm just going to try and get all of the Galarian forms. So Galarian Ponyta, Galarian Slowpoke, etc. And then I don't know what I'm going to do, like, after that, but before Gen 9. At least right now. I want to say I'll do more shiny hunting for, like, other Galarian Pokemon, but I don't know. Oh, speaking of shiny hunting and Galar, there's an event right now. If you're watching on YouTube, by the time you see this, it's going to be way too late to download it. But there's another event for Shiny Meryl, which is interesting. And actually a little annoying because that's like the 3rd or 4th repeat event that we've gotten this year, I feel like. But yeah, if you download the Wild Area News, there is a boosted odds for Shiny Meryl. And that means that you can get Meryl and Azumarill. Or Azumarill, however you're supposed to fucking say it, the evolved version of it. Only problem is that for me, I already have that entire evolution line. In fact, my Azumarill I got from the last time they ran that event, so. But yeah, so that's going on right now. I'm trying to think if there's anything else. Oh, yeah. I think I'm done with Pokemon Go, I think. I actually, part of my burning out wasn't helped by, I missed the community day last week. The one for, Dino, however you pronounce it. And then, the one that evolves into Hydreigon. I completely missed that event. I didn't even do it at all. And then they announced the next one, and it's going to be for Starly, so I'm just... I think I'm just done with Pokemon Go. I don't think I care. I haven't loaded it up in like 3 weeks, to be honest. Okay. That might be exaggerating a little bit, but I mean, it has been at least a week. But I would really like if we got another Wild Area event that's like for new Pokemon, maybe? Unless they want to, like, repeat Tauros or something. Like, one of the Pokemon that I skipped early on. I guess I didn't skip Tauros. I just, never actually got the shiny. I was hunting for it in the Wild Area event, and then I got bored, so I stopped, and then I never went back to it. And then eventually I overrode that one. That event. So I never got it. So I guess I'd be okay with that one. Not really, though. I would like to just see new shit. Because it's not like I'm the only person who shiny hunts. Oh, I haven't checked Pokedex Tracker in a while, too. I don't remember if I mentioned, but last time, I think I did last time I streamed, that Jed had traded me a bunch of new stuff, and I haven't, like, updated any of the stuff. I updated the Pokedex tracker, but I haven't, like, updated the info cards that pop up on stream. So I need to do that eventually. But we'll see. Maybe one day Pokedex tracker will update. I don't remember if I mentioned this on stream last time too. I might have checked after that stream, but I think Pokedex tracker has just been abandoned. The last update that they've said anything about it was when they added the regional decks for Legends Arceus, which was like in mid-February. And even the GitHub, the only thing they've updated in like months is the like supporter file that just lists all the people that have donated to the project. And even that was updated like a month ago. So I don't know. There's been a few things that have kind of combined at once, which are part of why I've been a little burnt out. What's up, Salsa Shark? Welcome back to the stream. But yeah, I found that really interesting. I hope that, like, website isn't abandoned, because, like, it is pretty useful, even if it isn't perfect for what I want, but it's fairly well organized and laid out for showing off the Pokedex. 46 boxes in on this thing. You mean a Galarian Slowpoke or a different hunt? And also, oof. That's like, do you have like a shiny charm and everything? That sounds like a lot. A lot. That can't pop. Masuda plus shiny charm. I guess that would be like 1200. That's crazy though. That's like really bad luck. I'm sorry to hear that. Let's hope mine doesn't take that long. Almost triple odds. Yeah, it's definitely getting up there. Because, yeah, that's like in the ballpark of 1300. You've done over 2,000 eggs in Sword and Shield, never got a shiny. That's like crazy. But, I mean, it is possible. And, you know, it's theoretically possible you could do 20,000 eggs and never get a shiny. Extremely unlikely, though. Masuda plus shiny, yeah. Well, that's the thing about it, though. Doesn't matter how many you do, you're no more likely to actually get the shiny on any given egg. So you just kind of have to keep going at it. What are your plans for the Slowpoke? Are you going to make it into a Slowbro or a Slowking? I actually don't remember which one I'm planning on making mine, now that I think about it. I think I was going to make it a Slowbro. Maybe I'm wrong about that, though. I just have to look at the stats and figure out, because I think, what am I breeding for it? Alright, so it looks like I'm making it a physical attacker. Slowbro, I'm not a monster. Okay. Trying to think, how many other Pokemon have had a like separate branch in their evolution line added after the Pokemon was originally introduced? Like Slowking was. I don't think it's very common. Alright, I'm gonna take these eggs out because they're absolutely gonna start hatching again. Eevee. Okay, yeah. I guess other than Eevee, because I feel like Eevee's kind of cheating. Poliwag. Okay. Another Gen 2 Pokemon. Steelix. Alright, outside of Gen 2 then, how many other... Well, also, Steelix is kind of cheating too, because that was just a new evolution was added. It wasn't like, Scyther, yeah, that's a good point. And Snorunt, yeah. Okay. So it's more common than I was thinking. I just couldn't come up with any examples off the top of my head. It still kind of upsets me a little bit that Scyther got another evolution. Meanwhile, Pinsir still has nothing. That should be all of them. Pikachu, kind of. Yeah, I mean, I wasn't really counting the, regional forms in that. But I guess it's effectively the same thing, right? If you called the... Galarian Pikachu, or sorry, not Galarian, but Alolan Pikachu or Alolan Cubone, any other name, then it would be exactly the same. So yeah, I guess that makes sense. But yeah, I don't know. For some reason, I was thinking that wasn't like a thing that they had done very often, but like, obviously they have. It's like a branch Evo. I mean, yeah, I mean, it basically is. Chimecho. Chimecho is a baby form. They've done a ton of baby evolutions. I mean, that's what Pichu and Azurill and all of like the Gen 2 babies were. And there are more in Gen 3 and 4 as well. Have there been any baby forms added since Gen 4? I feel like they haven't done that. Chingling is the baby. Yeah, I know. I'm saying though, it's the same thing as like Pichu and all those. Though that is absolutely the stupidest one they ever did that with. Hey, here's Chimecho, this Pokemon that pretty much sucks in like every possible way. Desperately needs a evolution to make it viable in any way. Here's a baby form for you. Have fun. Anything that can't breed is a baby. Not anything, because like unknown and stuff like that can't breed. I guess I shouldn't say stuff like that. There aren't many examples, but there are a couple. Chimecho is your favorite mon. All right, well, unfortunately, its stats and moveset aren't not necessarily stellar. It's not a bad design, though, by any means. It really did need, like, an evolution, not a baby form. I really hope one day they... Anything that's a preview that can't breed is a baby? Well, yeah. I don't know, were there any re-evolutions that were added that can breed? I can't think of any really off the top of my head. Unless, like, can Magby or Elekid breed? I don't think so. Those would be, like, the only ones I would suspect off the top of my head. Yeah, I do hope, even though it seems pretty likely they're not ever going to do another baby form, I hope they add something as an in-between because, or, like Tauros and Miltank. Okay, so Magby can't. I didn't think it could, but for some reason I was thinking they, Magby and Elekid might have been the exception to that. Wheat Buddy, I don't have any commands set up in my chat, so I don't know what you were hoping that would do. Alright, one more egg. Most recent baby is Ryolu. Well, Ryolu was also added in the same generation as its evolution. But yeah, so I guess all the Gen 4 babies would be the most recent one. Unless 6, 7, or 8 added something. I know for an almost fact Gen 8 didn't. In fact, not even almost, I know it didn't. I'm pretty sure 6 or 7 didn't add anything. In terms of baby forms, anyways. Also, speaking of things that I hope don't come back, hopefully trade evolutions are just done. It kind of seems like it, since Gen 8 didn't have one, and Gen 7 only kind of had one because of a lowland golem. And especially with them adding the linking cable to Legends Arceus. Hopefully that's just a mechanic they're just going to let die. Because, yeah, I think the last trade evolutions were Aromatisse and Slurpuff. I don't remember if, Trevenant and, Gorgeist as well. Yeah, Gen 9 just had, Alolan Golem, which was a kind of a new trade evolution, but since it was based on the original Golem, it's like, eh. And then Gen 8, there was nothing. But at least they've been better, even besides that, just like letting you be able to catch the trade evolutions in the wild. Because that's pretty much how I got all mine in this game. Like, specifically Aromatisse and Slurpuff, I just, you can catch them in raids. Pretty much all of the trade evolutions are in raids, I think. Same with, like, Excelgor and, whatever the other one is. Can't like remember the name off the top of my head. I keep on saying Excadrill, but I know that's obviously not right. That's very much not the right Pokemon. Escavalier, there we go. I knew it was something close. But that's also like the only one that those two trade evolutions that like I would be okay with them keeping is purely trade evolutions. Or I would tolerate them being purely trade evolutions. Maybe not be okay with it, but being that they're like the only one that has actually explained how that works as a trade evolution. But everything else, please, for the love of God, give us the linking cable. Or like, you know, stuff like Rhyperior. Or Rhyperior. I always want to say Rhyperior, but it's Rhyperior. But stuff like that, where it has its own item, like, just let me use the item on it, please. Hopefully they, certainly saw the reception to that in Gen, or I guess technically it is Gen 8, but in Legends Arceus. God, I'm so excited to see, just to see what Gen 9's gonna be like. Hopefully it's good. I mean, realistically, I enjoyed the hell out of this game, so like, well, the bar isn't very high for what I need for it to be an enjoyable game, but hopefully they at least don't take any steps back from this. Okay, today would be great. Thank you. But I definitely want to see some sort of, like, raid co-op system. I know there's going to be, like, open world co-op in the new games, which is cool. I just hope it works well, because, I mean, the wild area is kind of a disaster in this game. But hopefully with just, like, a couple people running around, it isn't as bad. But yeah, I do hope we see some sort of raids and some sort of Dynamax Adventures return. I don't necessarily want to see them be exactly the same because, I mean, they both kind of have their issues. Namely that, raids are, like, just kind of not that interesting after a couple of them, because they all kind of stay exactly the same. And it's just like, okay, let me load in my overpowered Pokemon and smash through it. Like, I like having the option to do that, but like, maybe it shouldn't be as easy to do. And also, you kind of had to do that because the AI is garbage. That's the biggest thing with like raids and Dynamax Adventures or anything like that, is just make the partner AI even remotely competent. Just like, even remotely competent, please, for the love of God. It would make it so much more interesting. And as far as I know, the AI in Legends Arceus is actually, I was gonna say dynamic, but maybe that's not the right term, but it does have, like, different levels of difficulty within it. Like, alphas and stuff are, have a, like, smarter AI as opposed to wild Pokemon and stuff like that. What I would really love to see, and this isn't gonna happen, I know this isn't gonna happen, but, like, some way to actually, like, the more you play with certain partners, the better they get. Just like, maybe they start off with like a level 5 trash Pokemon, and like, they use moves that don't make any sense, but like, the more you use them in raids, the higher their levels get, and the better their Pokemon, I guess higher levels, better Pokemon are one and the same for the most part, but like, making better choices in terms of like, moves and stuff, just like, that would be pretty neat. I don't think there's any way in hell that happens, because why would Game Freak bother to put that much effort into it, but it would still be nice. I would love to see it. And then, like, I could put up with the AI being trash and, like, early battles sucking or being frustrating or whatever, because it's like, well, later on they're going to be, you know, a lot easier and a lot more interesting. It would also, you know, let you choose your AI partners as well. Because then you would actually have, like, a reason to, like, try and level up certain partners and stuff like that. So that way you can have, you know, better coverage for opponents and stuff like that. I feel like that could be pretty cool. I don't know how you would do it with Dynamax Adventures, since you're basically handed a Pokemon, but that's another thing. Dynamax Adventures, like, if there's any sort of equivalent, please let us use our own fucking Pokemon. I understand why they didn't do that, because the AI is fucking terrible. And so if they let you do that, you would just smash through it the same way that you smash through it in normal raids. Just bring in a level 100 Dracovish and vicious rend everything. But like, please just like make the AI not terrible and then let us use our own Pokemon, because we'll actually need to, you know, need to use our own Pokemon to have a chance. I mean, we still have it where, like, if you come in with something level 100 EV trained and all that stuff, like, yeah, it should be a lot easier, you know? But, like, just, God, let's use our own Pokemon again. Because the fact that, like, even before the AI has any effect on the battling in Dynamax Adventures, you can still load into a Dynamax Adventure and you've already lost. There's like, there will not be a single super effective Pokemon, or maybe one, or you know, two at most, but then like the AI will switch off the super effective stuff anyways. Just like the fact that you can lose without, before you've done a single battle, before you even chosen a Pokemon and you've basically already lost, is like, that's such a shitty, not fun feeling. Like, unless they're really gonna like commit to making Dynamax Adventures a roguelite, which I don't know if I would like that, but I wouldn't necessarily hate it. But also, that's, my feelings on that is irrelevant, because that will never fucking happen. Again, that would require a lot of effort for a side feature, and I don't think that's gonna happen. Certainly not from Game Freak, anyways. God, I'm really, really interested to see what, if anything, is going to happen from that, the leaked emulator for GBA, or Game Boy Advance, and I guess Game Boy Color, so I set those out of order, whatever. But yeah, there was an emulator, like an official Nintendo emulator for those games on, or those platforms on Switch that got leaked. Kind of the same as the NES, SNES, N64. I think there was one for the GameCube and the Wii as well. Because that's how they did the Super Mario 3D games that they did in like the triple pack with Super Mario Sunshine and Super Mario Galaxy. Those were just emulated, I believe. I know for sure Sunshine was. I don't remember exactly if Galaxy was. It might not have been. But yeah, I really hope they do something with that. I really hope it means we get, like, the Gen 3 games. Or Gen 1, 2, and 3 actually would be pretty dope. Just have those games brought over to the Switch. Because I don't pay for the expansion pass for Nintendo Switch Online, because why the fuck would I? There's no reason to for me right now. There's a couple of like N64 games I'd be mildly interested in playing, but like I don't care enough to pay more money for that right now. But if they were adding the Pokemon games, as soon as the first of those games hit, I would probably, well, now that I think about it, I'm not sure, maybe not. I think the first of the Gen 3 games to hit, I would probably pick up the expansion pass. I don't really have an interest in playing Gen 1 just because it's so jank. I've never actually played through the games, but like everything I've watched them, it's just like, yeah, this is, I'm happy to let this stay in the past. At this point, if you want to play the Gen 1 games, just play Fire Red or Leaf Green. That's pretty much what I've heard just about everyone say, other than like the most hardcore of Gen 1ers. And then I actually completed Gen 2 Well, so I owned Gold and Crystal back in the day. Those were like my intro to Pokemon. Those were like my intro to video games, pretty much. I mean, I had some other games. Like, I had the Tony Hawk, some of the Pro Skater games for PS1 and stuff like that. But so Gen 2 Pokemon was very early on in my life. But not all that long ago, I actually completed Crystal on the 3DS just because I wanted the Celebi. And then I basically got handed two shiny Celebis by Pokemon Go, and I think it was a code event for Sword and Shield as well. So, whoops, but oh well. See, I don't know. I don't think I'd be too interested in going back to Gen 2 at least right now. But I've never played Gen 3. And that I've never played Ruby, Sapphire, or Emerald at all. I never played Fire Red or Leaf Green. I've never played the Gen 3 remakes on the 3DS, so that would be really fun to play through. So yeah, like any of those drop. And also, those are like the first games that like use like the modern mechanics. Other than the physical special split, which was introduced in Gen 4. But pretty much everything else important was added in Gen 3. The EV-IV system, abilities, nature, I'm pretty sure. I think nature's added in Gen 3. Maybe Gen 4 at the latest. Pretty sure Gen 3, though. But yeah, it's like, there's like the, you know, Gen 1 and 2 are like very jank. But those were like the first ones with like all the modern stuff, or most of the modern stuff. You like overarching mechanics that are core to the series. But I don't know. I have no idea if they'll actually add those, because like they haven't done anything with a GameCube emulator that they had made for Super Mario Sunshine, so who knows if we'll ever see those Pokemon games. I would hope so, especially with the 3DS eShop going down pretty soon here. I say pretty soon. I think we have like another 9 months before it's like gone. But I think we have already passed the point where you can't buy games using a credit card or any sort of like bank card anymore. But you can still buy like the gift cards or whatever and add money that way. But I think that goes down early next year or something like that. And then it's like a few months later that just the eShop's going to be down. There's not going to be any way to download the games anymore. So even if you own the games, you won't be able to re-download them. Which is why it's recommended that if you have a 3DS still, like, to go download Pokemon Bank and make sure that's installed on your 3DS. Because even though the eShop's going down, the bank servers will still work. And they're actually making it, because right now it's a paid service. It's like $5 a year or some shit. It's pretty much meaningless. But even if you, once the eShop actually goes down, like, all the way, and there's no way to pay for stuff anymore, they're actually going to make a bank just free, which is nice. But hopefully, being that there won't be any way to access that stuff anymore, hopefully they'll use the, you know, the GBA emulators and just like put the old Pokemon games on Nintendo Switch Online. I'd rather just they be purchasable, but like, it's Nintendo, that's not gonna happen. They've kind of made it very clear at this point that if you want to play old games on the Switch, you're gonna have to pay for Switch Online, which really sucks. But I don't know, it's like, I don't know how I feel about the subscription model for that type of stuff. Because on one hand, it's nice to like only pay a little bit of money and have an access to a big library. And like, for the most part, most games I'm not gonna play more than once, you know? Like, if with Pokemon games, if they came to it, I would, you know, I would play through probably Emerald and like Fire Red. But like, I wouldn't play them again after that because I wouldn't have a reason to. It's not like I would want a shiny hunt in those games. I don't think there's any good mechanics for those. Maybe Gen 2 I would shiny hunt, but that's just because the way that shinies worked in Gen 2 was kind of busted. So if you did it right with breeding, you could get like 1 in 50 odds, or even better than that, I think, for breeding for shinies. Because it was like based on the stats of the Pokemon if it was a shiny. And so if you had a shiny Pokemon already and you put it in there to breed it, it would like, you would have pretty good odds of getting another shiny. But I mean, so like, that's the thing. It's like, I don't know. Like, yeah, in theory, I'd rather just own the games, but also like, if I'm never going to go back and play them again, what's the point of me paying $30 for them? Because let's be honest, it's Nintendo. They're not going to be cheap. I guess, to be fair, the Gen 1 and Gen 2 Virtual Console Pokemon games on 3DS weren't too bad. I think they were like $10 or something. But like, I don't know. Either way, it's kind of irrelevant because, again, I don't think there's any chance in hell that you'll be able to just outright buy those games. But I wonder if, because I mean, that leak for those emulators came out a few months ago, and I wonder, and maybe this is just me really desperately hoping that they'll actually come out with games for them, but hopefully now that the Pokemon Home got updated, part of what they're doing and part of why we haven't seen anything for those emulators yet is they're actually gonna make sure that the virtual console games will work with Pokemon Home. Oop. Oh, right, I didn't. Goddamn it. Go away. I fucking hate when I do that. Forget to take the Pokemon out of my party. Because that would be nice to be able to get, just be able to transfer over your Pokemon like that. Especially, I was gonna say, especially with Gen 1 and 2, but on, like, with not being able to download Bank anymore, you're basically not gonna be able to access any Pokemon from before Gen 8. Or I shouldn't say won't be able to access any Pokemon, but you won't be able to, like, catch Pokemon and, like, Fire Red or Black 2 or anything like that and transfer them over. Like, yeah, if, you know, you hunt down a 3DS that already has Bank installed, but like, those are gonna be expensive. Hell, I'm thinking about potentially like making sure that's installed and then wait like 2 or 3 years and then, or like maybe even like 5 years and then sell my 3DS. Actually, if I was, well, I guess I only have Crystal. But yeah, if I was really smart, I would like go download, or I would have bought all of the Gen 1 and 2 Pokemon games and installed them onto my 3DS as well. I'm not going to do it now. I think the gift cards, I forget what the actual name for them are. The like store credit cards or whatever that you can like go to like Walmart and buy. I'm pretty sure those do still work currently. But like, that's too much goddamn effort. Yeah, I really hope that Gen 9 just has like every Pokemon. I don't know how likely that is, I hope at bare minimum every Pokemon that hasn't been available on a Switch game yet will be in Gen 9. So stuff like Go-Goat and Deerling, stuff like that. Because, you know, once the eShop goes down and you can't really get new downloads of Pokemon Bank anymore, like, there's going to be a lot of Pokemon that you're not going to be able to access. Like, we'll be able to access everything from Gens 1 through 4, thanks to BDSP. And then obviously, like, Gen 8, but, like, 6, or 5, 6, and 7 is going to be a little bit spotty. Which is a little worrying. But yeah, like, ideally, even if they're not, like, in the Pokédex in the Gen 9 games, I hope that every Pokemon is in Gen 9. Just for that reason by itself, that would be a good reason. Like, I understand that, like, people want all the Pokemon all in all the games, but, like, you know, even besides the fact, like, that's just how it should be to begin with, but, like, hopefully they do that just to so we don't have this issue where there's going to be Pokemon that we can't access anymore. But yeah, again, short of that, hopefully they at least prioritize the Pokemon that are going to be very difficult to get. Unless their goal is to, like, try and push Pokemon Go for that shit, but God, please God, don't. Also, Pokemon Go doesn't even have all the Pokemon. Is Go-Goat even in Pokemon Go at this point? I feel like it's not. I feel like I have not seen that Pokemon in Pokemon Go. Granted, there's a lot of Pokemon I've not seen in Go, but, like, still. I love how I didn't go and actually get this egg when I was, after, like, I moved out the previous set of Pokemon. Alright, come on. Let's see a shiny tonight, please. Would really like to have the shiny tonight. If not by tonight, then for the love of God, tomorrow. If I do get it tonight, I've been going for about an hour. I'm not sure. I think I'll probably just wrap up at this point if I got it tonight. And then tomorrow we just do some hunting in Legends Arceus. Yeah, I also don't know if I'm going to go back to Minecraft right now. Just because, I don't know, I can't, like, since I'm kind of leaning towards just going to 3 days a week, I kind of like to just do Pokemon on those 3 days. So I guess we'll see. One more. I know I just checked, but there's so many times where I'll check and then I'll close the menu and I'll have already forgotten what I just looked at. Come on. Oh my fucking God. I'm gonna do one more circle and then she's gonna have another fucking set of egg or another egg ready. Just watch. But if I don't do that, then I'll hatch, like, 3 eggs before she gives me another. It's, like, the only... It's really not an issue or complaint, but it's just the only thing that bugs me ever so slightly. And it's more that it just bugs my OCD, but... Having, like, the eggs hatch before, like, you have the full set... And it's only a problem with, like, well, I guess the majority of Pokemon are 5k steps or under. I am glad that I got the, that Fionn, even if I'm not, like, too keen to go back to BDSP for breeding at any point right now. But I am glad that I got the Fionn. Hey, what's up, Jed? But I'm sure at some point I'll have to go back to BDSP. Well, I guess that does depend on Gen 9, though. If Gen 9 has every Pokemon at least importable, then I'm not going to have to worry about BDSP ever again. Honestly, I might even consider uninstalling BDSP at that point. I just, like, don't care about that game anymore. Which is a shame, because, like, I did enjoy playing through it, but it's just, I've got really no reason to play more of it. Other than for, like, shiny hunting. I guess, to be fair, I don't have much reason to play Sword and Shield anymore, except for shiny hunting. But, being that breeding is just straight up faster in this game, like, you know. Only reason to go back to BDSP is for stuff that I can't get in this. God, I have... I don't know why I have this itch, like, right on the edge of my nostril, and it just will not go away. It feels almost like a hair is, like, tickling it or something. Even though that doesn't really make sense. He's hatched. I guess this is the egg that I spent quite a while writing and not getting. Okay, there we go. Yeah, hopefully breeding in Gen 9 is not going to be too bad. I mean, I can't imagine it's going to be bad. But just hopefully there's, like, a decent spot to just, like, ride back and forth in. And hopefully it isn't somehow slower to ride than in this game, like they did with BDSP. It's so weird that that is, like, the case. Because I really don't feel like just the boost on this bike accounts for all of that. Though, again, I haven't actually ever bothered to look it up, what, like, the difference is. So I guess maybe it could be. But it feels a little bit more pronounced than, than just the boost. Need more caffeine. That was 3, right? Yep. Also, another thing I need to do, which would be like the main reason why I would even go back to BDSP right now, is I still need to go get that Ditto. That shiny Ditto that I keep on putting off. Last one? Was the last one nice? But just, I know I'm not, like, gonna want to do that hunt. Also, I need to, like, actually set up my counter properly for that again. Because I had, like, a whole other setup for it. And in theory, it should still work. Though, actually, I think I was so frustrated with that shit, I actually went through and, like, commented out the lines of code for that stuff, but I mean, that takes me like 10 seconds to fix. But like, I just need to like actually set up that scene again properly. Yeah, that was by far the worst luck I've had with the shiny hunt. Like, even a Registeel, I'm not even, you know, at odds yet. But I mean, that one was way over odds. Actually, let me see if I still have that picture. So 743 resets, so whatever that is, times 4, which I think is in the ballpark of 3,000, so like, close to double odds, which I guess isn't that bad, but I mean, it was over like 80% likely to have seen the shiny Ditto by then. Alright, let's... Oh. Hatch this egg, and then we'll check that thing for a shiny. Maybe I'll be able to actually kill this one. I really do need to go and fix this Chandelure. Just give it something that hits decently hard, and isn't like ghost type. So that way I can still hit normal types. Problem is, it's only 70% effective. I'm sorry. Let me, okay. The reason why I want to knock this thing out is it's, it helps just to have more encounters. Because there's, like, tiers to those, aura Pokemon. Oh, God. That might have been a mistake. Okay, well, we didn't hit the point where I have to, like, start deleting moves yet, so I guess it's not the end of the world. Yeah, it's not, like, really worth it to do that, because, honestly, it doesn't, like, make a big difference. You have to get up to 500 encounters to get to the best odds, but still not awful. And I think at 500 encounters with like shiny charm and everything, it does get down to around 1 in 500, so... Oh, we can go turn in Pokemon and... Do this. Good thing none of these had perfect stats. That'd be a little bit annoying to, if, like, you got traded a Pokemon with perfect stats, but then, like, it already had, like, 2 EVs and 1 stat. It's like, god damn it. I have to go and clear this damn thing before I actually, like, train it at all. I guess, to be fair, I'm probably not going to really trade any of these. I think they're all just going to get released. There we go. See the 3 or 4. Was really hoping that was 4, but oh well. Yeah, I guess going way back to talking about like cleaning up my like game libraries. on Steam and Game Pass, or Xbox, I guess. Hopefully I'm gonna start like clearing through some of that stuff again, because there's like some games I want to go back and play again. Like probably the main long one that I want to do is Tomb Raider, the reboot from like 2013. I just remember having so much fun in that game on PC. I never actually got too into the sequels to it. I bought the Rise of the Tomb Raider, and I played it a little bit, but I never got very far into it. And then Shadow of the Tomb Raider, I just never got to, because I didn't even finish the previous one. And I don't think that's going to change. I don't think I really care about going back to those other two, but I would like to play through Tomb Raider again, because that was just such a fun game. Yeah, there's some other stuff like that. Let me pull up the list real quick here. Let's see. Yeah, I want to go back and play through Halo again. Final Fantasy 13 2. I might not actually play through all of that, to be honest. Let me do it this way. Okay. But yeah, Final Fantasy 13 2. I think that's just going to be a... Oops, actually move this to make sure it's not covering chat. Okay. But yeah, like, Final Fantasy 13 2 is another one that I loved the hell out of. I understand it's not a great game, it's just kind of a guilty pleasure, but, like, I shouldn't even say guilty pleasure. I loved it for the gameplay. It was so much fun. I understand the story is just kind of stupid, to be honest, but it was so much fun to play that. Final Fantasy 8, which, like, I kind of credit that as being, like, the game that got me into the video games. Like, yes, again, I had played, like, Pokemon before that. I had played, like, Tony Hawk games, stuff like that. But I never... I was still too young to actually have any understanding what the hell was going on. I was just kind of hitting buttons at that point. But yeah, Final Fantasy VIII, I've never actually beat that game. Like, I've done playthroughs of it a couple times, or tried to do playthroughs, and I just never got very far with them. Like, I don't even think I've ever... Other than, like, my original, when I played it as a kid, was, I don't think I've ever even gotten past the first disc. My, like, original playthrough, I got up to pretty much the end of disc 3. And then it was like, okay, well, I guess I need to do, like, all the side stuff before. Because, you know, with disc 4 on Final Fantasy 8, that's like point of no return. You can't go back. So, I just, like, never got around to doing it. But yeah, I don't know if I'm going to do that, though. Because, like, I just don't have time for, like, long playthroughs of shit anymore. Like, I'm still working on the Mass Effect trilogy again. And that one kind of take priority over a lot of other stuff. Yeah, Final Fantasy 15, just because, like, that one I'm kind of very doubtful that I'll go back to, because, like, I started it, kind of cleared, like, the first chapter or two, and then, but this is when, like, not quite sure why I saved there, to be honest. But this is when, like, I had a job, but, like, I had just started, like, kind of living on my own, so it's just, like, I was buying a bunch of games, because, like, holy shit, I have money. And I still kind of had time to play games at the time, but I was just, because I was jumping between stuff a lot. Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to go back to Final Fantasy 15. I would kind of want to go back to it on PS4, just because I have, like, the Steelbook edition, but also, like, my PS4 is broken, and also I kind of don't care. I'd kind of rather play it on PC just because it'll look better. But then the last Final Fantasy, which are on this list anyways, which I do really, really, really want to go back to, is World of Final Fantasy. That game actually shares a lot with Pokemon, actually, which is funny because it is like kind of a creature capturing game. But God, that game was just like, it was so derpy and fun and just like didn't take itself seriously at all. It had a lot of like references, not even references, but just like straight up pulling characters from other Final Fantasy games. Like Quistus, actually, from Final Fantasy VIII. It's just like, which is like such an odd character to pull, because you'd think like, oh, Squall or maybe Rhinoa. But like, no, they pulled Quistus for it. But it was, you know, I never got very far into that game, but God, I need to go back and play it. That is a game I think I'm going to pick up on the Steam sale within the next couple of days here, too. I have double my time on Twitch than playing games nowadays. Yeah, I mean, that has been like the nice thing the last couple of days. I've actually been like going back to playing other games instead of just Pokemon, which is why I haven't been streaming as much. But yeah, that eventually I need to go back and play through Borderlands the free sequel. Not because I want to play through that game again, but because I never played through the Claptrap like expansion DLC, which apparently is like one of the best pieces of Borderlands content ever. I just never got to it because the free sequel is it's not great. I don't think it's terrible, but it has to live in the shadow of Borderlands 2, and it just does not compare. Borderlands 3 as well I might go back to, but I don't know, because I have to go download the Epic Game Store for that, and I just don't care enough. And also, I think I'm content with being done with the Borderlands series. I do, because I own pre-sequel on Steam, and I have, like, the Claptrap DLC and whatnot, it's like, and knowing how good that is, it's kind of like, well, maybe I should, but, like, Borderlands 3, I didn't get very far into that game. I kind of don't care. Yeah, Tomb Raider, Torchlight 2, that one's kind of questionable, but it's a very fun game. Also, I guess I do still have that save as well, because it's on Steam Cloud. But yeah, and then Thomas Was Alone. I kind of want to go back to that just because it's a very, very fun, very short puzzle game. Like, maybe 2 hours long. So it's like, well, I can go back to it, play through it real quick on, like, just an afternoon, and then just be like, okay, cool, we went back through that. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of it. Minecraft Dungeons, that's another one. I need to go back to that one. I've done, like, a couple different playthroughs of that, and I've gotten, like, near the end, but not quite through it. Hey, what's up, Artsy Bug? Yeah, working on Glare and Slowpoke. Hopefully we'll get it soon. I'm hoping to get... Not even hoping, I will get up to 500 hatches tonight, so... Hopefully we'll get it. Because, I mean, we'll be basically at odds. But yeah, I'm working on getting, we're trying to get all of the Galarian forms, so like Slowpoke, Ponyta, stuff like that. Get all of those before Gen 9 comes out. Finally got done with a week-long hunt for Shiny Sableye. Got one in a Love Ball in mail. Nice. Were you breeding for it, or did you have to catch it? Because that's definitely a lot more impressive if you had to catch it with a Love Ball. As opposed to just, like, having another one and breeding for it. Probably switch over the music to another album. Hold on a second. Let's just do the most recent one. Hopefully Harris Heller puts out some new music soon. Yeah, I was breeding. Still took forever. Yeah. That's the thing about shiny hunting. Doesn't matter how many eggs you hatch. Still doesn't get any more likely that any given egg will give it to you. I would kind of like to see some sort of pity system for breeding. Like, maybe, like, say, with Shiny Charm and Masuda method, see it, like, alright, you bred 1,500, you're guaranteed a Shiny. Because, I mean, you're not very likely to get up to 1,500 eggs without seeing a Shiny. It's just, like, you know, just have some mercy with it. But I guess it could be kind of a pain in the ass to set up that system properly, because, like, what if you swap out your Ditto to a not Masuda method one or something like that? Don't always have love balls to spare. Is love balls one of the apricorn balls? Or I guess one of the balls that you can't just buy in this game. You have to like go use the Cramermatic or whatever. I can never remember what balls are like the pain in the ass ones. I know some of them like sport ball and stuff like that. I think heavy ball as well. Safari ball. Some of them I know are pretty rare. It's got three shinies, two of them back to back. Esper got a shiny early on, and then two more back to back and egg apart. Nice. Yeah, the only luck I've had like that was in Legends Arceus. I got shiny Bergmites on back-to-back spawns. I caught one in an outbreak, and then the next one that spawned to replace it was also shiny. Which was also really awesome, because that was the last shiny hunt I did in the normal outbreaks before updating to the update with mass outbreaks. So it was like a really awesome way to cap off all those hunts. I think it's probably safe to assume at this point we're not going to get another content update for Legends Arceus, which is kind of a shame. I know it's still possible, but I feel like they might have... either we would have seen it by now, or they at least, they would have, like, mentioned something about it at this point, I feel like. Didn't even think it was possible to get shinies back-to-back on eggs. I mean, yeah, it's just extremely unlikely, because, I mean, you're landing back-to-back 1 in 512 odds, so possible, but not very likely. But yeah, I've seen it happen before on streams. I've never had it happen myself yet. You almost one-tapped a shiny Bisharp, was mindlessly leveling, so just spamming attacks. Decided to pay attention right before I chose attack. Hey, so you didn't do what I did with my first ever shiny years and years ago in Heart Gold, where I was grinding for speed IVs, or EVs rather, and I knocked out a shiny Magikarp because I wasn't paying attention. Yeah, I would love a reason to go play some more Legends Arceus, like an actual like content update. I will probably play Legends Arceus at least a few more times before Gen 9 comes out, because I still have shiny hunting to do in it. But I would love to have another content update, but I don't think it's gonna happen at this point. We've got like 4.5 months before the new games come out. I highly suspect that Game Freak is all hands on deck for the new games, so it's unfortunate. First shiny you got in Pokemon was Whismur and Oraz. Ironically enough, got a shiny one on the first day you hatched. Nice. Nice. Jesus Christ, I can't speak. Yeah, up until Gen 8, I didn't really have any shiny Pokemon. I had gotten a couple in Pokemon Go, but like, other than that, and I think all of those were from Community Days. I didn't realize that's what was going on at the time, but I think that's where I got them all. But yeah, I don't remember what my first shiny in this was. Yeah, I really don't remember what my first one was. Oh, I think it was a Punkaboo, actually. Badoo for short. Come on, man. This is supposed to be a safe place, man. I thought I escaped Legends Arceus. I didn't have to see that fucking thing anymore. God, that fucking Badoo. What is it, 5 of the damn things I've seen in Legends Arceus? But no, I think it was a Punkaboo because the Christmas after Sword and Shield came out, so like a month after the game came out, I bred a fuck ton of the trade evolution Pokemon because for on Christmas I was gonna send them all out as mystery gift Pokemon, and just one of the ones I got happened to be a shiny. I was like, okay, well I'm gonna keep that one. So yeah, I had bred like a box of like Punkaboo and did I have Trevenant? I don't remember. I don't remember what all I did. I think did I have a Slurp? Maybe I didn't do Slurp Up. I don't remember what they all were, but they were all trade evolutions, and they were pretty much all Pokemon that didn't need an item for the trade evolution. And then at some point I got like a random shiny not Dragalege, but whatever like the unevolved form of that is, the like the seaweed dragon Pokemon thing. Skrill, that's what the name of it was. But yeah, I was breeding that to I was actually gonna make a competitive mon with it. Yeah, it was Skrill. Thank you, Artsy Bug. But yeah, I was working on that, and just while trying to breed a competitive one. I say competitive like that Pokemon was particularly competitive to begin with, but yeah, just like had a shiny pop on that. I was like, oh, cool. But other than that, pretty much all of my hunts have been like specifically hunted for. Oh, and some stuff in Dynamax Adventures as well, but that's God damn it. That's not what I wanted. Let's go ahead and run away from the... Unless I can... I guess this is super effective. Okay, I guess we'll knock it out then. But yeah, I always like to at least check those, damn it, did it again. I like to check those, the Pokemon with the aura on them. Oh, god damn it. Alright. Don't want anything to learn Yawn. Please go away. I know why they don't let you do this, but god, I wish they would just let you mash B and just get through this really quickly. Like, when you get up to that choice where you want to decide if you want it to, learn the new move or not. Like, just let me mash B through that, please. I know why you can't, though, but I wish it would be, like, an option in the menus or something. Then again, you have to get like an hour and a half into this game before you can even like change the audio options, so maybe that's asking for too much. I can't believe they put the audio options behind an item in this game. A very easy to miss item, by the way, too. You just have to be like talking to literally everyone in town and happen to find the guy that has the key item for it. God, please don't do that again, Game Freak. That was, like, one of the stupidest things they did with this game. that. God damn it. I fucking hate it when you have a sneeze that, like, you can feel. And it's like, it's gonna happen. It's gonna happen. And you're like, try to look at a light to make yourself sneeze and shit too, and it just doesn't happen. Any day now, you can give me another egg. Thank you. I suspect we will be hatching an egg, blue-balled by a sneeze. Yeah, seriously. Like, I don't like sneezing, but fuck, if I'm gonna feel like I'm gonna sneeze, at least make it happen. Especially because you sit there looking fucking stupid as hell for like 10 seconds. It's like, oh my god, please, just let it end. Alright, I'm gonna pull these out of my party real quick, because these are absolutely gonna start hatching with how long this is taking. I really wish... This is another thing I would love if they would change in Gen 9. If they can make it so that, like, the daycare could store up to, like, 5 eggs, and you could just grab them all at once. God, that'd be so nice. I know it would be a little bit faster to just do circles in front of her the entire time and just swap out Pokemon as they hatch, but I figure this is already bad enough for my for the Joy-Cons. Plus, doing it this way makes it pretty easy to organize. But yeah, it'd be so nice if you could just, like, go hatch your eggs and then come back and just pick up another set of 5 and then immediately go back out and hatch more. There we go. I almost went into that door. That would have been annoying. Also, I really hope they don't put the daycare, or the egg giver, I guess, for the daycare right next to the door again. The number of times that, like, I've been doing circles around there, or, like, I, you know, get my last egg so I leave to go start hatching, and it just, like, you accidentally go into the door, and it's like, oh, good, okay, let me just waste, like, 30 seconds in transition screens here. I'm exaggerating a little bit, but it's still annoying. Get this tonight, come on. Especially because I put off streaming last week because I just, well, again, Saturday and Sunday, I just got screwed by work, so I couldn't really stream. But yeah, like, during the week, I mean, I probably could have streamed, I just didn't feel like it. So now that I'm a little bit behind schedule, even though I have plenty of time, because again, I've kind of given up any hope whatsoever, and I didn't have much for this, but I've given up any hope of getting all of the new Gen 8 Pokemon before the new games come out. But getting all the Galarian forms, I know I can very easily do. That shouldn't be an issue. God, I would really like to get this knight so that way I can just have it done and start working on something else. I think I'll just go up to 500 tonight. I'm not gonna worry about going past that. I do have a bit of a headache. Yeah, if we get this tonight, then we'll probably just do Legends Arceus tomorrow. Well, either Legends Arceus or I'll hop into BDSP and work on... Whatchamacallit, Ditto. Because that's another one I just need to get done. And then I think for the time being, I'm not going to be doing any shiny hunting off stream. Just because that is part of why I didn't feel like streaming last week, as I was just been kind of burnt out. Oh, right, I hatched everything, you fucking idiot. There's a perfect one in there, at least. Gee, I wonder why nothing's hatching. It's been a little bit. Oh, right, because everything already hatched, you fucking imbecile. Alright. I need to take everything out, right? Good. See, and again, this would be a perfect situation for that, because then it wouldn't, like, set me back too much if I could just grab 5 eggs at once. I do wonder if they would ever do that. Or if that's just, like, a change they don't have any interest in making just because it would make it go too fast. Although, honestly, with how much stuff they've made so much easier with, like... with, like, making competitive Pokemon and stuff like that. I kind of feel like that would just make a bit of sense. But I guess that would make the, that would make shinies more common, and with how hard they, like, came down on that shit in Pokemon Go... Although, I don't know, because it was still super easy to get shinies in Legends Arceus. I don't know. Because I can't count to 5. I just grab an egg every time I pass the egg lady. Just swap out eggs for another 5 already in the box. It makes sense. I mean, I can't really count to 5 either. Well, obviously I can count to 5, but, like, the moment I look at how many are in my party, I, like, the moment I close the menu, I forget. Because I got the brain of a goldfish, apparently. But that's why I just check, like, 37 times every time I'm collecting eggs. Alright. Third monitor shows up tomorrow. Nice. Yeah, I need to look into redoing my setup soon here. I don't think I'll be hopping to a third monitor anytime soon, but it would be nice to set up another one. Just order some, like, really cheap garbage on Amazon. As long as it's, like... I was gonna say as long as it's 1080p, but honestly, I'd be fine with 720p, even. It's just... it needs to not be outrageously overpriced like it would be if I go to, like, Target or something. And the, Best Buy near me actually closed down. Though, from what I've heard from one of my friends, that might be a damn good thing, because those guys were actually complete scumbags. they like really tried to fucking screw him over on a TV. That they basically sold him a broken TV and then tried to get out of replacing it. So I don't know, maybe it's a good thing that they closed down, but it is like, god damn it. For whatever reason, I like to keep a lot of tabs open, so two monitors wasn't doing it for me. It would be just nice for me, so that way I could have, like, a game full screen on, like, the main monitor. So, you know, Minecraft, because that's the only PC game I play on stream. Yeah, I can have the game be full screen, and then I would, be able to have, like, the stream on another screen. Or, like, the OBS on another stream. Screen. God damn. Yeah, like, I do have it's not a storage unit, so I'd have to go get it, but it's an old-ass, like, 4x3 monitor. It's, like, 1280 by 1024 or something. Which I used to use that, and that thing, I mean, it's fine as like a second monitor, but it would kind of like something that's widescreen, specifically just for putting OBS on it. But yeah, I do want to look into redoing this office setup at some point here. The big thing that I need is I need an actual, like, microphone, arm. Because this whole putting it onto a cardboard box that sits in front of me is, you know, not exactly convenient. Again, for PC games especially. Monitors on sale, but the taxes still wanted to eat my ass. Would have been too much if it wasn't on sale. Yeah. I am very glad that I kind of splurged when I, bought this monitor. Because previously I had an Asus, like 1080p monitor. I mean, it worked perfectly fine. It had, like, one HDMI, one DVI, one VGA port. But, like, it had pretty good picture quality. It was 60 hertz, you know. It was basic, and, you know, it wasn't very expensive. Let's go ahead and fix that before I forget. But that thing finally... I had that thing for... 7 years? And then it finally died, because I was, like, moving, and it just didn't survive. It did survive the move, because I used it, because I had to temporarily set up my computer to mess with something. I had to, like, pay a bill or something. I forget exactly what it was. So I just set it up, plugged it in, set it up real quick, unplugged it, then, like, actually set my stuff up, like, the next day, and it never worked again. What's up, Dark King? Welcome to the stream. But yeah, so I actually had to live with just that 4x3 monitor for a little while. And then this one was like I knew I wanted a good monitor because I wanted another one that was going to last me for a long time. And so this one, it was like between this one, which was, it's 1440p and 144 hertz. It's an LG something or other. Very good picture. It's HDR, but it's like HDR 60 or whatever the bullshit one is that isn't actually HDR, and so you probably shouldn't bother using. That monitor's living off borrow time. Yeah, it was, I mean, it was, it had a good life for me. I definitely missed that thing, because it was, I wish I could have kept it as like a second monitor, but also if it had never died, I probably would still be using it. Yesterday I got 17 shinies and PLA, so today is all sword and brilliant diamond. Nice. Yeah. Legends Arceus is good for that. But yeah, I've gotten all of the brand new Pokemon that were introduced in Legends Arceus. So stuff like Overquill, but also stuff like just Hisuian, Quillfish. I got all of those in that game. So I'm back to Sword. I'm just working on trying to get all of the Galarian forms at least. So like Galarian Slowpoke, or also like Ponyta, stuff like that. Trying to get all of those before the new games come out. I wanted to get all the new Pokemon, like Squovit, stuff like that. Or the starters, I guess, is the better example. But I don't think that's gonna happen at this point. So yeah, I was debating between this monitor that I got, which was like already like $500. Or there was like an $800 4K one. And it was basically, it was the same thing. It was 4K, 144Hz, you know, all the good stuff. God damn it, I didn't clear out my party again. Whoops. Then I hit the wrong button again. Jesus fucking Christ. Why am I so bad at this? I'm literally just breeding Pokemon. How am I so bad at breeding Pokemon? But yeah, I was waiting for a while because I really wanted that that 4K one. Just because, again, I don't want to have to always be upgrading monitors. And even if, like, I don't really have, even still today, I don't really have the graphics card to be running 4K. It's like, you know, I don't have to run it in 4K. I can run it in a low resolution. Doing Dynamax adventures for at least one shiny legendary before the new games. Nice. I was working on legendaries a little bit in Dynamax adventures, but I can't do that AI anymore. So I'm gonna at least wait to see until the new games come out and see if there's gonna be a good way to shiny hunt legendaries in that. And then if not, then I guess I'll have to come back to this. But yeah, for the time being, I'm not doing any more Dynamax adventures. But yeah, that monitor, like, I was just waiting for a while. Because, I mean, this was, you know, like October 2020. So, you know, COVID was still in pretty swinging pretty hard. And everyone was still working from home pretty much. And so eventually I was like, okay, I'm just going to pull the trigger on the lighter one or the smaller one. Kind of glad I did that. Just because, you know, just running everything, running 1440p instead of 4K is such a big difference in terms of being able to power that. I feel like if I had three 4K monitors, my PC would blow up. I mean, just for the desktop, it's not too bad. But yeah, if you wanted to like play a game in triple monitor, yeah, your PC would melt. I think even with the NVIDIA's like dynamic, or I guess it is dynamic upscaling. I forget what the exact term is, but the AI upscaling for resolution stuff, I think even that would struggle with 3-4K. Unless you have like a 3090 or something. Also, I'm so happy to see graphics card prices go down. Can't relate with monitors because you use a TV. I mean, it's most of the same stuff. You know, the standard resolutions are the same. I don't know how I don't think 1440p is very common for a TV. But yeah, I mean, like, some of the inputs might be a little bit different and stuff like that, but I mean, it's a lot of the same stuff. The biggest thing is that it's, like, impossible to find a fucking TV nowadays that isn't loaded with smart TV bullshit that no one actually wants, I feel like. Actually, I shouldn't say that. I think a lot of people like having that stuff, but Jesus fucking Christ. If there's a point where I go to the settings menu on my TV and there's a fucking advertisement, I'm punching a hole through the fucking thing. Fuck off with that shit. God, that stuff pisses me off so much. I don't think I could ever buy another TV just because of that. I want to say, like, Spectre might still have a dumb TV, but other than that, I mean, there aren't really any good options. And, like, honestly, if I want, like, the smart TV type stuff, I'll just get, like, a Roku or a Fire Stick or something. But yeah, it's nice seeing graphics cards actually being affordable again. I think I saw that the price on them has crashed like 50% since January. Like, I'm not going to go out and buy one because my 2070 is still doing fine. I've only had it for like a year. I only got it because my buddy upgraded. Well, this was his 2070, and then he upgraded to a 3080 and spent like $2,000 on a $1,000 graphics card. Still not sure why he did that. Like, I understand shit was scalped to all fucking hell, but Jesus Christ, dude. Like, at that point, just like save a little bit more and go buy a 3090. Like, fuck, dude. Fuck crypto bros, yeah. Man, I don't necessarily have an issue with people gambling their money on crypto stuff. It is gambling. Let's not pretend it's anything else. It's not at all stable. I wouldn't even call stocks like an investment. Unless you're like investing in the major indexes or whatever the term is for stuff. You know, the stuff that's like fairly consistent growth. Like if you invest in Apple, okay, sure, by all means. Apple's a pretty good bet. You're not, you know, gambling your money. You're going to make a consistent return whenever you sell that shit. But like, for most other tech or most other stocks, it's, you're just gambling. Just call it what it fucking is, people. But yeah, like, I don't mind people doing that. I just mind that crypto made fucking graphics cards so fucking unaffordable for so long. And also all the NFT shit. That NFT shit actually pisses me off. Because that, oh my, I have zero sympathy for anyone who has been like scammed with the NFT stuff. It is the most like blatantly obvious stupid shit. But I'm pretty sure I've gone off on this rant before on stream, so let's not go back down that one. But yeah, I'd rather put my life saving on black like a real Giga Chad. Honestly, compared to like some of the fucking meme coin shit, that's probably a better bet. Actually, to be fair, the meme coin shit is not necessarily a bad bet as long as you understand that you have to get out before the rug gets pulled. So buy in early and sell very soon after as well. Problem is, every stupid motherfucker thinks that every stupid fucking meme coin is gonna be their ticket to being a millionaire. And then the creators pull the rug out from under it. It's like, whoa! I want no, absolutely no regulation except for when it affects me, and then I want it to be regulated. Same rant against it anyway. Slimy show. Oh my god, slimy show poke. I'm tired. Yeah, I hope I get it soon, too. Yeah, I did also see that, NVIDIA is actually, I don't know if this is confirmed or if it was just a rumor, but they're actually gonna, they aren't requesting as much silicon wafer, or I forget exactly what it was, but they aren't going to be getting as many, they aren't gonna be making as many GPUs up front as they were expecting to because of how hard crypto has crashed. So they know that, like, they're not gonna be selling a bunch to coin miners. What's up, Directly RJ? Welcome to the stream. Which, one, kind of confirms that, yes, crypto was a huge part of the issue with the GPU shortages. I mean, we've kind of always known that, but NVIDIA was very much like, no, it's not a supply issue, it's a demand issue. But it's like, right, but if you have a demand issue, that means you have a supply issue. Just, like, call it what it... Like, I understand that early on, like, there was a lot of people screaming about it being a paper launch because it felt like that, but it really wasn't. I understand that. But, like, also, like, Maybe if you guys weren't letting people buy, like, 10 fucking 3080s to just go throw into a fucking mining rig. You know, that would be nice. And, like, I know that's not entirely NVIDIA's fault. It's more on the retailers that were... did a piss-poor job of fucking, you know, not letting people scalp the shit out of stuff. But, like, still, goddamn. GPU prices are great. It's time to get a second PC. I mean, to be fair, I do have the hardware right now, I think. Actually, not even think. I know I could. Only thing I need is I think I need a new motherboard for this, this other, CPU that I have. Because my buddy, same one that gave me his 2070, like 6 months ago, managed to dump a bunch of water in his PC. And mind you, this is with the fucking 3080 that he spent $2,000 on. Somehow it didn't fry the 3080. I don't know how the fuck he did that, because he spilled it in through the top of it. But he fried something on it. Because the, something with, like, the RAM didn't want to play nice anymore. And it was like, okay, well, it's, 2K for a 3080. Yeah, I mean, this was back in, like, January 2021. So, like, absolutely scalped to fuck, but also, like, it was either buy the scalped ones or really be patient with trying to find a, find one actually in stock on a website somewhere. He was still stupid for doing that, but yes, he spent $2,000 on a 3080. That's a 3090 pre-build, homie. That might be a little bit of a stretch, but yeah, I mean, it was... I even told him, it was like, dude, you should just, like... If you're gonna overpay for a scalped card by that much, you know, like, you probably could have gotten a 3090 scalped for, like, $2,200, you know? But he was just super impatient on it, so he's like, okay, well, I guess you're just gonna pay the tax. And I wasn't really in a hurry to stop him, because, again, I was getting his 2070. And my card before that was a AMD RX 480, so, you know, it had been, like, 6 years since I bought a graphics card. 2K before tax. I mean, still, the 3090 was a MSRP at 50, I guess, to be fair, MSRP. So not whatever the pre-builds were paying, but yeah, that was, like, a 1500, so, I mean... 500 for the rest of the system, probably not great. But yeah, I mean, like, again, I wasn't really in that much of a hurry to stop him from doing that, and I had already told, like, it wasn't like I was encouraging this, but I had told him, like, this is a stupid, like, you shouldn't do that, but he did it, so, hey, his fucking money. I'll take the free graphics card. Much like I got, more free shit from him when, again, he fried the fucking motherboard on that system. How he didn't fry that graphics card, I don't know. I really don't know. Yeah, I don't know if that mother... Because I actually, let him crash into a wall for a free GPU. Listen, I warned him otherwise. He can make his own choices. And I have stopped him from really stupid stuff. He was going to get into, like, NFTs and shit. I was like, dude, fucking don't. Even if you think, like, oh no, I know it's fucking stupid. I'm just, you know, I'm gonna try and, you know, get in and make a quick buck. No, don't. And he didn't, and what do you know? He made the right choice there. But yeah, so I actually have his old, because after he did that, I went over to his house and we basically, we bought him a new CPU and GPU, or not GPU, sorry, CPU motherboard. He bought RAM, even though I think the RAM probably was fine. I think it is the motherboard that got fucked. But he was like, no, I want to buy more RAM anyways. In case you haven't noticed, not the best decisions with money sometimes. But the, although, to be fair, I don't completely blame him because there was something not quite right with the RAM. How did he get water in his PC? He knocked over a glass of water onto it or something like that. I didn't really ask too many questions. He just, like, texted me one day and was like, hey, I think I just killed my PC. I was like, oh, good. So he actually, he took it to a repair shop to, like, make sure, because I didn't really have any way to, like, And I don't currently either have any way to, like, test that stuff. Even though I don't know if they really did that, I think they just pressed start on it and looked for what codes came up. But anyways. Or not codes, but you know what I mean. But anyways, so yeah, he got a new CPU. Because he had actually been wanting to, he had a Ryzen 5 3600. And he had been wanting to upgrade. Which I actually didn't realize that he played a lot of strategy games. So, like, he actually, I didn't think he was going to get use out of a better CPU, but, like, he actually does have a reason for it. Yeah, so he upgraded to a 5700 Ryzen. A new motherboard and stuff. So I actually have his old motherboard and CPU sitting on my desk. That's also how I only had 16 gigs of RAM at the time. I now have 32 gigs, and I have two extra 8 gig sticks just in case. Dude, my PC is so far away, that will never happen to me. Yeah, it'd be pretty difficult for me to do that. It's next to me, but it's under the desk where, like, it would be really impressive. Because it would have to, like, leak around the desk and then back over towards me before dripping down. But yeah, I can see how that happened. I mean, I've had my computer in places before where that could have happened. All right. Just a few more eggs here tonight, and then we're going to wrap up. But yeah, I may have, when the new Ryzen chips were announced. The, like, 7000 series. I did kind of message, like, hey, there's going to be new AMD CPUs pretty soon here. I don't think he's going to buy it on it, because I even told him, you shouldn't upgrade to this, but, like, just so you know. I might actually upgrade to it, because I could actually get some use out of it, but we'll see. Again, if that stuff gets scalped hardcore, stuff like that, I'm not going to worry about it. My 3700X is working just fine. And if I need to, I can overclock it, because I do have a dual rad cooler for it. It's going to get scalped, no question. Yeah. Oh, I don't think I'd buy it before, like, January. Because, I mean, I... Even before all this stuff happened, I mean, back with the, My Intel 6700K... I paid, like, $70 over MSRP for that thing. Because it just... You couldn't get them for a while, and so it's like, okay, I'm just going to bite the bullet on this. So, yeah, it's like... It's supposed to be $350. I think I paid like over $400 for it. But yeah, so I mean, like, I know that shit's gonna happen. I'm not gonna run out to go get it real quick, but I would kind of like to upgrade to it. Although, I also really don't want to have to buy more RAM again. Because the new Ryzen chips are... They're purely DDR5. Like, I know the most recent Intel launch was some boards had DDR4 and some had DDR5. Ryzen's just not even going to mess with it. It's just, nope, you have to do DDR5. Which I don't mind. It's just that I've had to upgrade my RAM recently, like within the last couple of years. So I would like to not do it again. In fact, no, it was just like a year ago. It was not even like 2 years. I guess a year and a half anyways. They should do some pre-orders. I mean, I'm sure they will. And I'm sure those pre-order slots are going to get taken up immediately. And then, once those get fulfilled, it's going to be a freaking madhouse. And then... We're going to see what happens with, NVIDIA's 4000 series GPUs. I know, Intel just launched their, like, their standalone GPUs. Maybe not standalone, but, like, they're not integrated GPUs. They're, like, discrete ones. And boy, those are not good. They're like not good at all. I don't know if you can get like an actual card for them or if they're just they're only for laptops right now. But yeah, they're like, I watched the Linus Tech Tips video and it's not great. Like, it's good that it's gonna happen. I'm sure they'll get up there eventually. So I'm new to this PC stuff. Do GPUs drop price when new ones release? Typically? I mean, it's usually not like a big drop right at release, but yeah, I mean, same as anything, you know, the prices are gonna start to go down a little bit. And one thing that does happen a lot, and what a lot of people did and then got bit in the ass with, is that people will, they'll sell their old GPUs either once they get the new ones, or even with the 3000 series. A lot of people did this. Don't do this. They sold their GPUs before they had the new ones, which fucked a lot of people over because 3000 series was real hard to get. Yeah, so getting those used ones is usually, I mean, you can usually get a good deal on those. Oddly enough, the coin mining rigs, actually, right now getting those cards is actually a good idea. People think it's not a good idea because the idea is like, oh, these cards are being pinned to the max 24/7 and they're super hot and shit, so they're gonna, you know, they're gonna break pretty soon after you buy them. Actually, not usually, because usually people will actually undervolt the cards so that way they use less electricity, because that's your running cost with coin mining. And so those GPUs are actually good to get, and when they sell them, I mean, they're just trying to flip the thing so they can go get new ones. So, especially right now with how crypto has gone, everyone's just trying to get the fuck out. So, you can actually pick up a used 3000 series for probably a good price right now. Anyways, let's go ahead and... But yeah, typically, like, once the 4000 series comes out, you'll see the 3000 series go down a little bit in price. We didn't really see that with most when 3000 came out because everything was so fucked at once that like people went out and kind of panic bought old GPUs because they realized that shit was going to be a mess, and then so you couldn't get those anymore. So yeah, no shiny today. Fuck. Really wanted to get this shiny. Let me go through the last few boxes here. I do actually want to make sure that there wasn't a shiny in this. God damn. I think we started from here. Because I do have this slight paranoia that I was just kind of autopiloting during some of this. Wow, that was very lucky. I'm breeding for attack IVs. So that's like incredibly lucky. I'm going to pull that one out. Because I'm going to use that when I want to make a... when I do my next shiny one of this. Hold on a second. Let's go ahead and move this. Alright. Oh, we'll put you in there. Yeah, I just want to go through these real quick. Make sure there isn't a shiny in here that I missed. I don't think so, because, I mean, it's a pretty obvious shiny. I'm not too worried about grabbing one of the best ones because, like, I probably have a few of them, and the one that I'm actually breeding right now might even have 6 IVs. God damn, how did I get 2 of those? It's crazy. But yeah, definitely, no shinies, which, again, I didn't think I had missed one, but it was a good idea to check. But yeah, pretty soon here, it should be a good time to buy new PC hardware. Especially if crypto keeps on crashing, because more and more people are going to be getting out. Alright, but also, depending on what you have, also... there might not be any point in upgrading. Again, I was running an RX 480 for 6 years. And honestly, up until I got this monitor, it was pretty much fine. It struggled a little bit with trying to do 1440p, especially on newer games, but I mean, you know, it is what it is. So yeah, don't feel like you need to upgrade, because honestly, old stuff lasts for a lot. It keeps up for a lot longer than we realize. Anyways. Alright, so I'm going to wrap up. I guess tomorrow will be more Shiny Slowpoke, or not, well, hopefully Shiny Slowpoke, but we'll be breeding for it. And then we'll see. I mean, Monday and Thursday I'm not streaming. I'm going to just say that from now on. We'll see what happens Tuesday or Wednesday. We'll just have to see what happens, because again, I'm not sure if I'm going to be trying to stream on those days anymore. Especially right now, as I've gotten kind of close, or I'm getting closer on getting up to 50 followers, which is like just kind of two main metrics for getting an affiliate. It's average 3 viewers a stream, like, what's the term? 3 like concurrent viewers. So like just getting to 3 unique viewers every stream isn't enough. You have to on average have 3 people watching you all the time. And then you have to get up to 50 followers. So I'm kind of like leaning towards doing less streams just to try and get that average viewer up a little bit. And then once I get to the affiliate, I don't give a shit anymore, because at that point, once I have it, I have it. It doesn't matter. And just so that way I can have some more features on the channel and stuff. But definitely, I mean, assuming no more work shenanigans, we'll see. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we'll just be doing more shiny hunting. And assuming I get this, probably what we'll do is if I get this tomorrow, the Slowpoke, Tuesday or Wednesday, if I do stream, will be either Minecraft or Legends Arceus. And then Friday and Saturday, we'll probably be looking for Shiny Ditto in BDSP, so I can just be done with that, not ever worry about it again. Just be done with it. Be done with that fucking hunt, that goddamn demon. And then we'll just figure it out from there. Yeah, thanks everyone for watching. You know, if you're watching this on YouTube, subscribe, all that stupid bullshit. I do try and upload all my VODs. I actually need to go through and double check all my stuff. I think I have something that's set to private that's supposed to be uploaded soon. I think I still have, actually, you know what? I can look right now. But I think I still have at least one that's, not come out yet. Let's see. And that is, like, scheduled. Oh, no. Sorry. So the last one that was scheduled and hadn't been put out yet came out yesterday. So, perfect time for me to do this. So, yeah, this will be up tomorrow at 10 a.m. Though, I guess if you're watching this on YouTube, then it's already... Anyways, point is, I upload all my stuff. I do highlights, all my shinies, all that shit. Anyways, thanks everyone who watched. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you guys next time.